Science fiction is make-believe that has much of its basis in fact, some connection to what is provable and known. On the other hand, the occult is largely based on superstition and myth. And what we see on screen doesn't necessarily need to have its roots in anything real. In this regard, the next Star Trek is unusual. Some fans consider it to be a supernatural yarn. It carefully blurs the line between science fiction and the occult. We'll hear voices from beyond the grave, from the souls who once inhabited a long dead planet, and we'll see a woman's body and mind possessed by spirits. And all this in a story that predated William Peter Blatty's head-spinning horror tale, The Exorcist, by about 4 years. Now, the lights of Zetar. You might recognize the name of one of the writers of this episode, puppeteer Sherry Lewis. No, Lamb Chop isn't here, but Sherry's wonderful imagination is. Listen closely to this episode's musical score. Sound familiar? If the answer is yes, it's because you've heard it before. The producers borrowed the score from Where No Man Has Gone Before. Both episodes feature unknown alien forces, so the music works here just like a charm. Scotty really is unlucky in love. Maybe it's because although he's fond of the ladies, he's fonder of machinery. How many other times has he come close but no cigar? Well, there was the dancer that he was accused of murdering in Wolf in the Fold and getting jilted by Lieutenant Carolyn Palamas, who chooses the god Apollo over him and who mourns for Adonis. Better luck next voyage, Mr. Scott.